We were working again with Apple's system and Final Cut, and Francis had taken over the lease of a building in San Telmo, one of the neighborhoods of Buenos Aires. And so we had the whole building, and the whole production company was based in this building. The art department and the costume department and the administration and editorial and camera department all came out of this building. And we had a projection room, which we built from scratch. It's easy, relatively speaking, to do this because of the digital revolution. We have a digital projector, and to economize even further, but also to explore what it was like, we decided to put the editing room in the projection room so that one corner of this fairly large room that held probably 40 people was my editing bench and the other paraphernalia of working. And then I hooked the editing machine up to the digital projector so that what was on the screen, which was a 30-foot screen, 10 meters wide, was whatever was on my editing machine. So that I was editing, I could just turn and look, and it's as if I'm in the theater watching the final result. And this has been kind of a holy grail thing, that, you know, a thought that you think in the back of your mind, maybe someday we can edit and see the image on the big screen. But in fact, that's exactly what happened in this case. To compensate for the fact that normally I don't have that luxury, what I do is I have the screens that I'm working on a kind of intimate basis here, but then I also have the screen, have that information sent to a liquid crystal or plasma screen over there, maybe a 50-inch screen. And if I want to check something, I look at that, and I also have cut out two silhouettes of a man and a woman, scaled appropriately so that if I place them on either side of the screen, I can imagine if those people are 5 foot 10 inches tall, that that screen must be 30 feet wide. And this is a very good, very simple technique to remind yourself what you're working on is not a miniature, but it's a mural. That this thing is actually going to be projected sometimes 60 feet wide, 20 meters wide, sometimes more. And when that happens, the relationship of the audience to the screen is different than when they're looking at the screen. It becomes more of a look into than a look at. In fact, you could distinguish between, let's call it home video and theater, as home video, by which I mean also broadcast television, is a look at medium. Theater is a look into medium. That at home you see the entire frame and the image kind of bounces back at you. It's as if there's a little visual ping pong ball that bonk, hits the thing. Whereas in the best sense, what happens in a theater, especially when the film is a good film in every respect, you are no longer sitting in the audience watching this film, but you are imaginatively, like Alice through the Looking Glass, you have plunged through that surface and you're in that world with these people, experiencing it along with them. Alternatively, you could think that has leapt off the screen and has jumped into your head. There's a kind of a simultaneous leap inward and outward. You have gone into it and it has come into you. And there are reasons why this is true that have to do with the kind of subject matter that films get into versus what television gets into. And it's also the experience of watching a film with lots of other people, which adds a peculiar and very hard to define dynamic to the experience. But essentially it means that the film is not there at your pleasure. You have to accommodate yourself to the film. To see this, you have to hire a babysitter if you have a baby and say the film begins at 10 minutes past 8. We have to get there, and you have to pay to get there somehow, and then you arrive on the moment and the film starts whether you want it to or not. That's when it starts. And that puts you in a different frame of mind, which I think is as important or even more important than whether the film is technically sharper at home than it is in the theater.